Hey everyone, I'm Marcos and I'm Moxie Boosted, and welcome back to another Pokemon Sword and Shield VGC 2020 video. Now, I just gotta let you guys know something. I am now an Excadrill main. I have seen the light, and I am maining Excadrill. Alright, well, obviously there's no such thing as a main in Pokemon. I mean, you can kind of main different archetypes. I know, in a way, I mained control teams in 2018. And some people like to play sand teams more than anything, but that's not what this video is about. This video is about how Excadrill is one of the most highly used Pokemon in the format. So if I hop over to Twitter right here, I probably should have had that open. Let me actually show you guys this first. Excadrill is at the moment the second most used Pokemon in Pokemon Sword and Shield VGC 2020. And I've seen a lot of people commenting on my usage stat posts, VGC stats. They run tournaments every weekend, Galar weeklies. They have been posting the usage stats for their tournaments, and that's actually really, really useful and important to the community. So for example, if we look at the first Galar weekly, let me actually go to media here so I can go through all them. Yeah, stats from December 9th. Let's start from the beginning. So week one, we have right here, week one, the top cut team was from Nails. He's actually a very experienced VGC player. He's been around forever. But as we can see, the top used teams all have Excadrill, and then we skip two teams, and then the rest have Excadrill too. So obviously, like, you know, the top cut teams, they all have that thing in common, and they're all running sand. Sand is very, very powerful right now. And I'm just setting all this up so I can make my case about Excadrill soon and explain to you guys how you can use them and how you should counter them, etc. Week two, we see Excadrill still won. Sorry for the blurry images. He was only missing from two teams on top cut, 000 AJ and Arctic Fish. They're the only ones missing Excadrill. And then the most recent one from this previous week, right here, it was the first week that Excadrill did not win, but we don't have to go too far down to find one, do we? Oh, no. Okay, so Excadrill actually just straight up didn't make it, but Excadrill was on most teams, as we can see at the bottom. In fact, if we look at the usage stats that I posted on my community tab the other day, by the way, follow VGC stats. It's one of the most important resources you'll need for succeeding in VGC. In VGC, Excadrill is at 50% usage, at least in these small tournaments, which online small tournaments will tell you a lot about what to expect from the format, especially early on. So as we can see, Excadrill at 50% usage, Tyranitar at 30 to 50, then Rotom, Whimsicott, and Dragapult. What we're essentially seeing is the dominance of sand teams in the format. In early format, that isn't too uncommon. Sand is a very hyper-offensive strategy, and hyper-offense tends to be pretty reliable at the beginning. If we go to Pikalytics.com, we can see that Excadrill's most used partners are Tyranitar, Braviary, Rotom Wash, Dragapult, Sylveon, Dracovish, Corviknight, Rotom Heat, a lot of Pokemon that we saw high usage of. So my case here is you guys are going to need to know how to beat Excadrill, and you guys are going to want to know exactly how Excadrill is used. So that's what this video is going to be for you guys. Thank you for clicking on it. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, or if you just enjoy it, leave a like, whatever. I'd really appreciate it. But yeah, let's get into it. So Excadrill has actually a couple of sets it can run, and I have some interesting calculations for you. So the reason Excadrill is so dominant right now is because it has so many tools to help it succeed in a format with Dynamaxing. First off, let's talk about non-Dynamax Excadrill. Of course, every Excadrill can Dynamax, but non-Dynamax Excadrill, if we're just not thinking about it, this is pretty much every Excadrill you'll see. This is the set. Stomping Tantrum or Drill Run, the trade-off is actually, it's preferential. So Stomping Tantrum is interesting because if it failed the previous turn, it's double power the next, which is insane. That's 150 base power if you manage to land it. So let's say they switch in like a flying type and it fails because it doesn't affect them. You can target the other partner and deal double damage. Iron Head for flinching, Rock Slide, or Iron Head for stab steel type damage and flinching, and Rock Slide for hitting flying types like Braviary, etc. And it can flinch, especially with its ability Sand Rush, which gives it double speed in sandstorms. So as you can see, there's a lot going for it. Excadrill also has the option not to run a Sand Rush set, but to run a Mold Breaker set, and what this will allow it to do is actually KO every single Rotom form except for Grass and Fan. Fan is the only Rotom form that remains immune to it, for one reason, and that's actually kind of hilarious. It's because it's flying type with Levitate. It was redundant, but it saves it in this case. Rotom Fan, not exactly the most viable Pokemon, though. But as for another reason that Excadrill can function so well in this format, the Dynamax bulk it gets from doubling its HP actually makes Weakness Policy a very viable item on this Pokemon. If we look at its usage stats, down here, the third most used item at 6% is Weakness Policy. Now, of course, Focus Sash and Life Orb are the two most common, but Weakness Policy is actually an interesting case. Basically, all Excadrill needs when Dynamaxed to live in opposing Excadrill's... I have high horsepower here, but it's 130 base power to simulate it being Max Quake. All it needs to live in opposing Max Quake is to Dynamax and have 60 defense investment. That's it, 60 defense investment. That is really, really awesome. It already has very high HP and low defenses, so that is something that it has the option to do. On top of that, if you get Excadrill to plus 2, it's already got an insane 135 base attack, so it's going to be dealing major damage with all of its moves. It retains its Sand Rush, so it's going to be able to not only set up the sand for itself using max Rockfall, but it's also going to be able to take advantage of that sand and get double speed, much like how rain teams will use, I don't know, max Seismitoad or max Ludicolo or max Dreadnought to do that. But what's really, really what puts Excadrill over the top is the fact that it gets Stab on two of the most important moves when it comes to Dynamaxing. That's Max Quake and Max Steel Spike. Now, Max Quake has up to, I think, 130 or 140 base power, and that is absolutely insane because it also will boost Excadrill's special defense stat, allowing it to live crazy hits like Scald, Hydro Pump, whatever, Earth Power from Gastrodon if it gets it this gen. I actually don't remember that. But regardless, it's able to live hits on the special side because of its high HP and boosted defense. On top of that, the Max Steel Spike lets it live physical things, so it makes it easier for Excadrill to live those fighting type hits. It makes it easier for it to live those ground type hits from like Rhyperior or from opposing Excadrill. In fact, if you Dynamax and get your Max Steel Spike or Max Quake off first, it makes it even easier for this Excadrill to get its Weakness Policy off. So that is just something absolutely insane about it. Now, looking at the top used Pokemon, that'll give us a hint as to how we should beat Excadrill. We can see some things like Rotom Wash up here, Corviknight, Conkeldurr, Gyarados, and Ferrothorn, and Rotom Heat. Also Gastrodon. So the reason that these Pokemon beat Excadrill so effectively, I'll actually go down the list right here. I'll go down the list in order of usage. So right here, we'll start off with Rotom Wash. Rotom Wash. So Rotom Wash, as you can see, has very low HP, however, it has very high physical defense. It's actually capable of straight up walling Excadrill without too much investment in its bulk. If we go ahead and take a look at the damage calc, Rotom Wash, the default set, 252 HP and just like 44 defense. Iron Head from Excadrill is only going to be doing, and let me turn off the Dynamax on this boy. Iron Head from Excadrill is only doing about 10% average, and it's immune to things like High Horsepower and Earthquake. But if you are facing a Mold Breaker Excadrill, you do need to be careful about that, because with Mold Breaker, it's going to be able to ignore your Levitate ability and KO you with a High Horsepower. Luckily, one of the most important parts about beating Excadrill is identifying the set. So Mold Breaker, you see it immediately if it has it. It'll say Excadrill breaks the mold, so you know to be careful about that. And Rotom's also capable of one-shotting it back with Hydro Pump. It can also give a Will-O-Wisp to it to burn it and neuter its attack forever. So that's why Rotom is such an effective counter to Excadrill. Next down the list, Corviknight. Corviknight isn't exactly a counter, but it just walls It walls Excadrill extremely effectively because of its high physical defense, access to Roost, as well as the ability to Tailwind up. Now, the reason Tailwinding is so important is because there are lots of Pokemon that are faster than Excadrill when the sand is not up, but when the sand is up, they are going to be outsped in O-Code. For example, Dragapult is in danger of being KO'd by Excadrill when the sand is up, if you're running a modest nature, because it's not quite that fast. So, or it's not that fast compared to Excadrill, Jolly Excadrill with the sand up. It's a very fast Pokemon, don't get me wrong, but with a modest nature, you're not boosting your speed, so it's not as fast. And it has low defenses, so it's not doing too well. So Corvenant being able to set up Tailwind for it will allow it to once again outspeed the Excadrill and threaten it with something like Fire Blast. So more in a supportive way, Corviknight's an excellent way of checking Excadrill. It walls it forever, and it's able to just help the team out, switching into hits for Excadrill, or switching into hits Excadrill wants to dish out, and just being a very effective wall. So next up down the list, we have Dracovish, which is, it's a very iffy counter, if you want to call it that. And the reason that's a very iffy counter is because it still takes a lot of damage from Earthquake and Stomping Tantrum and Drill Run. It switches in on Rock Slides and Iron Heads pretty well because it resists Iron Head and it has really good physical defense. But if you are running a Choice Scarf set and the sand isn't up, then of course you're going to Oko it. It's Dracovish. If you don't know, Dracovish has one of the strongest moves in the game, being Vicious Rend, which doubles power if it goes first, along with that being boosted by Strong Jaw, giving it an extra 50% power on top of Water Stab and the ability to run the Choice Scarf. So that's why it's kind of a counter, not quite though. It's not a reliable Excadrill counter in my opinion. Next up we have Conkeldurr. Conkeldurr has insane physical bulk, 105 HP, 95 defense. That is really, really good. On top of that, it's able to switch in on steel type hits very, very well, especially Iron Head. The only thing that it's really concerned about is getting flinched by Iron Head or Rock Slide. So as you can see here, Iron Head's only doing about 30% to a Conkeldurr. So you can put a little bit more defense in that, make it like a clean 3-shot, which it already is. So it's a clean 3-shot. It gets access to Mach Punch, which will do 50%. And if you're running something like Iron Fist, you're able to go before Excadrill every single time. So as you can see here, Iron Fist Mach Punch is doing around 70%, which is absolutely insane. If you put a Life Orb on that, this isn't like a common set, but this is a way that you could just always deal with Excadrill. But Drain Punch is your best option. Really, that's it. It's just a very bulky fighting type that takes hits extremely well. It resists Rock Slide. Drill Run and Stomping Tantrum are a little bit scarier because they can double in power, and Drill Run has the ability to crit, which is why I say that Switch is better in on Iron Heads than those. But yeah, Conkeldurr is just an overall nice way of switching in and either Okoing it or just hitting it pretty well. Ferrothorn. Ferrothorn is a Pokemon that absolutely walls, Excadrill, and the reason being, is because it resists rock, it resists steel, and it only gets hit neutrally by ground type attacks. And on top of that, all of Excadrill's ground type attacks make contact, meaning that if Excadrill wants to hit this thing, it's going to have to take Iron Barb's damage, which, as you can see, it does an eighth of its health every time it touches it. So if you decide just to go for something like a Leech Seed on that Excadrill, or even just Protect Stall it with Leftovers or something, you pretty much always win that 1v1, granted they don't have like a weakness policy boost. Because if we look at the damage calculator right here, Iron Head is only doing like 14% maximum. that's so disgustingly low, especially considering this doesn't have any defense investment, just HP. High Horsepower is doing around 30%, which is granted pretty scary, but if you get your Leech Seed off, you'll be recovering a ton of HP at the end of each turn, making this less of a 3-hit KO and possibly a 5-hit KO if you play your Protects correctly. And on top of that, every time they touch you, they're going to take damage, so Leech Seed damage plus the Iron Barbs will deal with it very, very well. Gastrodon is sort of an iffy one. It has pretty low physical defense, but it has access to Earth Power, it has access to Scald. Those two are able to do major damage to Excadrill because of its low special defense stat, and Scald's able to burn it as well. But where Gastrodon is a slightly less effective counter is because of its physical defense here. Once again, popping general Gastrodon into the damage calculator. High Horsepower is going to be a 3-hit KO after Leftovers. And that's with like a ton of defense investment. This is bold. So it's got boosted defenses here. However, Scald is a 2-hit KO, so you do win that. You do win that exchange, but any random crit or flinch could really screw you over there. So I don't recommend Gastrodon as a dedicated Excadrill counter, but more as just a general way of beating sand, or not beating sand, but beating rain on your own sand teams. So yeah, Duraludon, not a counter at all. Snorlax, not a counter. Rotombo, not generally considered a counter, more as a check, because much like Rotom Wash, it's able to switch in on Excadrill's steel type attacks and Wallum just as effectively. The only thing is it's not capable of Okoing. However, because it is able to switch in on those hits, Rotom Cut, it can sometimes two shot it back. It depends on how much special attack you have. Because you're cutting this in half every time you use it, you need a decent amount to guarantee the two hit KO. But you are able to burn it. So yeah, Excadrill, definitely one of the most threatening Pokemon in the formats. And it's just, it's so good. Just the ability to run things like Excadrill and Tyranitar next to each other, get your immediate sand up. And if they decide to switch in like water type Pokemon like Pelipper to set up the rain, they can go for their own rock type attack or their own max rockfall and set up the sand again. Just getting back their weather and doing major damage. It's a scary Pokemon. On top of that, there's lots of techs that they can run with it, like Sandaconda. So if you attack their partner Pokemon, their sand goes back up at the end of each turn. Excadrill is only getting better as the format progresses and people learn how to use it more effectively with its new tools. So yeah, definitely stay prepared out there, guys. That's all I really had to say for this video. I'm going to try to get some more well-edited videos out soon. My computer is broken, so I've been working off a laptop since Sword and Shield came out. But it should be finished. It should be fixed by the end of the month, so I can get some like real edited competitive analysis out for you guys. But that's all I really have to say for today. Let me know what you guys think about Excadrill in the format. I want to know what you guys think is the best Pokemon in the format in general. Comment it down below. Let me know. And yeah, with that, I'm going to call it, guys. Thank you so much for watching the video. Links to everything in the description. My Twitch, my Discord, my Instagram if you want to follow me there. But yeah, leave a like, subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice night. Bye.